गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू. एवरीबडी इज एबल टू हियर मी ऑल ऑफ यू?
यस मैम.
ओके, सो वी स्टार्टेड विद पेरिटोनियम इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास. होप यू विल यू साउंड लाइक चवी हैज मिस्ड द क्लास, सो वी विल रिवाइज लिटिल. सो व्हाट इज पेरिटोनियम? आई टोल्ड यू पेरिटोनियम इज ए थिन सीरस मेम्ब्रेन एंड आई टोल्ड यू वी हैव टू लेयर्स. The outermost covering what we have here is parietal layer, and the one which is very close to the visceral organs we call it as visceral layer. Okay, so parietal layer, from this picture you can make out it is lining the abdominal wall, and whether it is anterior abdominal wall or if it is behind, like right in front of the vertebra, you call it as posterior abdominal wall. So it is covering the abdominal wall, and whatever blue lining you are finding which is close to the visceral organ, you call it as visceral peritoneum. So what is the name of this visceral organ? I told you in my previous class, this is liver, stomach, transverse colon, small intestines. As you come lower down, I told you in case of females, we have three visceral organs in the pelvic cavity. Immediately behind pubic symphysis, we have urinary bladder. Behind this, we have
anal
canal. Uterus in female.
Uterus, sorry.
In case of females, it is uterus, and behind that we have rectum and anal canal. Okay. Now, the outermost covering, what we see, like just below, this is the anterior abdominal wall. We have parietal peritoneum. Okay, below which you have the visceral organs are closely invested by the visceral peritoneum. Okay, the peritoneal cavity is this yellow space, whatever you are seeing here. It's a potential space between the parietal and visceral layer. And in case of males, this peritoneal cavity is a closed sac, whereas in case of females, the peritoneal cavity is opening at fallopian tubes. Okay, so why are they opening at the fallopian tubes? Because it has to catch the ovum and bring the ovum in. Where? Into the ampullar part of the fallopian tube to facilitate fertilization. So for that purpose, you are finding it is open. Peritoneal cavity is open in case of females, and peritoneal cavity is completely closed in case of males. Okay. Now this picture, actually I told you, like the two lobes of the liver, in between the two lobes we have sickle shaped fold of peritoneum, that is falciform ligament. We should start tracing the vertical reflection of peritoneum. I asked you to write, nobody has submitted, but okay, the vertical disposition of peritoneum starts with the umbilicus. Okay, from the umbilicus it goes, okay, in the form of falciform ligament, which divides the liver into right lobe and left lobe. And between the two lobes, now you see this, the partition between thorax and abdomen is diaphragm. The inferior surface of the diaphragm is receiving the continuation of falciform ligament, which is coronary ligament. This is the superior layer of the coronary ligament. Okay, the tapering edge of this coronary ligament is right triangular. Tapering edge, the other side, you call it as left triangular ligament. Now, if you just look at this tracing here, if you start from umbilicus at this point, you can just go like this. Okay, so that means this red color is peritoneal covering. This black line is diaphragm, and red lining is parietal peritoneum. It is reflecting onto the liver between the two lobes in the form of falciform ligament. It will be completely enclosing the liver. Only small space of the liver will not be covered with the peritoneum. Like the parietal and visceral peritonea, they become continuous. If you just recollect pleura, I told you at the hilum of lung, the parietal layer and visceral layer become continuous. Similarly, here, when it comes close to the surface of the liver, you will see it is reflecting on the surface of the liver as the visceral peritoneum. Okay, so on the inferior aspect of the liver, this peritoneum becomes, now it comes close to the stomach. The connection between the stomach and liver, I told you it is lesser omentum. What is this connection? Lesser omentum. Now The reflection is continuing from the greater curvature of the stomach and it is hanging like downwards like a apron, what we wear intersectional. It is hanging like a big apron. You call it as greater omentum. The greater omentum is now coming behind and it is becoming continuous with transverse colon. Transverse colon. And the peritoneal covering which is now continuing is called as transverse mesocolon. What is the name given? Transverse mesocolon. Now the peritoneal reflection is like continuing on the posterior abdominal wall. Now it is coming down to enclose small intestines, and the peritoneal covering which is covering the small intestines is called mesentery. Mesentery. This will be repeated so many times during my lecture. Now keep listening carefully. Mesentery. Now once it covers the small intestines, again it comes back to cover the posterior abdominal wall. Now this posterior abdominal wall, and then now it is covering, what is this? Rectum. Now it is covering the uterus, then it is covering the urinary bladder, then it is coming back and like stopping at umbilicus. That means we started our journey at the umbilicus, and then we saw that peritoneum is covering each and every visceral organ and then coming back to its point of origin. So this is what is called as vertical tracing of peritoneum. Please read from your respective textbook the vertical tracing. Okay, you will clearly understand. I will share my PowerPoint also. Okay, did you understand or should I repeat once?
Can you please repeat once, ma'am?
Yeah, sure, beta. See, I started peritoneal reflection at umbilicus, parietal peritoneum. That is moving upwards and it is going below diaphragm. This black line is actually indicating diaphragm. Osteodiaphragmatic recess is here. So this parietal peritoneum is continuing below the diaphragm. Now it is coming close to the liver and closely investing the liver in the form of visceral peritoneum. Now all of the liver is enclosed by the peritoneum except for few bare areas, which I am going to elaborate when I teach you liver. From the liver you can see peritoneum is continuing its journey to stomach. Between the liver and stomach, the peritoneal extension is called lesser omentum. Okay, and the peritoneum is continuing its journey and it is forming an apron, okay, which is hanging in front of the visceral organs. This big apron, which is hanging from the greater curvature of the stomach, is called greater omentum. The greater omentum is continuing its journey by covering the transverse colon. Transverse colon. The transverse colon's peritoneal reflection is transverse meso. Meso word is used to indicate peritoneal covering anywhere. Now, because it is covering transverse colon, you use the word transverse meso colon. Now, it is continuing on the posterior abdominal wall. Now, it is coming down to cover the coils of so many small intestine. Only one coil is shown here. Okay, this fold of peritoneum which is suspending the small intestine is called mesentery. Enteron means intestine, meso is peritoneum. The peritoneal covering of small intestine is mesentery. Mesentery. Once it covers the mesentery, it is coming on the posterior abdominal wall. Now we know these three visceral organs. From posteriorly, if we continue the journey, the parietal peritoneum is covering the rectum, it's covering the uterus, it's covering the urinary bladder, and then it is coming back to its point of origin where we started at the umbilicus. Is it clear, Ritika?
Yes, ma'am.
So whole of this reflection which we have traced from above to below, coming back to the umbilicus, we call it as vertical reflection of peritoneum. Vertical reflection of peritoneum. See, here few things are elaborated. In fact, we started our journey with the umbilicus, with falciform ligament, of course the coronary ligaments. Okay, then the edges of coronary ligament, I told you right triangular and left triangular ligament. In my previous class, I told you this point as pubic symphysis. Pubic symphysis. From the pubic symphysis, what is the organ which is present below, behind the pubic symphysis? Immediately behind pubic symphysis, what is the organ we have?
Urinary bladder.
Very good. Behind the pubic symphysis, we have urinary bladder. Now see here, from the pubic symphysis till the umbilicus, we have one thickening of peritoneum which is called median, N, Nagpur. Median umbilical ligament. Now, thickening of this peritoneal covering immediately laterally, you call it as medial, L, Lucknow. Medial umbilical ligament. Medial umbilical ligament. More laterally, there will be one more thickening which is called lateral umbilical ligament. So how many together? We will have 5. I'm repeating. One median umbilical ligament, thickening of parietal peritoneum in the midline anteriorly. Now two, on either side of median, we have medial, L, London. Medial umbilical ligament. Adjacent to that, we have lateral umbilical ligament. So overall, how many? 2 lateral, 2 medial, 1 median umbilical ligament. So overall, we have 5 thickenings of the peritoneum in the anterior wall of the abdomen in the midline, extending from the pelvic region to the umbilicus, which we have used the words the umbilical ligaments. Okay, this picture is again showing us the same thing. Red line indicating parietal peritoneum from anterior and posterior aspects. Blue line indicating the visceral peritoneum, which is closely covering the visceral organs. Okay, where the parietal peritoneum is becoming continuous with the visceral peritoneum, as you see in the superior layer of the coronary ligament of liver. This I will expand and elaborate when we do liver. Okay, what is this connection between stomach and liver?
Lesser omentum.
Excellent. Now, very good. From the greater curvature of the stomach hanging like an apron, what is the name of this fold of
greater omentum?
Excellent. From the transverse colon, what is the name of the peritoneum?
Transverse mesocolon.
Mesocolon.
Transverse mesocolon. It's continuing its journey to enclose small intestines. What is the fold of
peritoneum? Mesentery.
Mesentery. The fold of peritoneum covering the intestine, small intestines, is mesentery. I'm very happy. So whatever pinkish area you are finding here, what is this pinkish area between the parietal and visceral peritoneum called as?
Perineal cavity.
Cavity.
Peritoneal cavity.
Peritoneal cavity.
Okay. So the outside red line is parietal peritoneum. We know parietal peritoneum is derived from somatopleuric layer of lateral plate mesoderm. I told you when describing pleura. Whenever somatic word is used, it will be pain sensitive. Visceral layer will be pain non-sensitive, insensitive to pain. So parietal layer, which is red in color, which is lining outside, is derived from somatopleuric membrane of lateral plate mesoderm. Hence parietal pleura, parietal peritoneum, whenever it is triggered or irritated, it will be pain sensitive. Whereas visceral peritoneum is derived from splanchnopleuric membrane of lateral plate mesoderm, hence it is pain insensitive. I already told you, male peritoneal cavity is closed sac, female peritoneal cavity is open sac.
Okay.
Where is it opening?
Fallopian tube.
Excellent, fallopian tube. What is the purpose?
To collect the ovum, fertilization.
Excellent, very good, Hemalatha. See here, this is all peritoneum only, beta, which is moving like this, covering the surface of the liver, coming down. This is lesser omentum, this is stomach. This fold of peritoneum, like apron, is greater omentum. It's going back, transverse colon, transverse mesocolon, so many loops of small intestines. This fold is mesentery. Okay, and our peritoneal coverings journey is coming back. This is rectum, anal canal, and this is urinary bladder. Is it male sagittal section or female sagittal section?
Male.
male because you are not finding the uterus in the middle. Okay, so you are finding it like this. This is female. You can see urinary bladder, uterus, and rectum anal canal. Here the peritoneum is taking its role. And we know in case of female, it is open. Where is it open? Peritoneum. Where is it open? At the fimbriae of the fallopian tube. Okay. Now, what are the functions? Let's take a quick review. It prevents friction. It prevents greater momentum. I will elaborate again. It prevents the spread of infection. It provides nutrition. It gives defense mechanism because it has macrophages killing the microorganisms. It increases the surface area of absorption. It excretes the waste products and it transfers the ovum oocyte. Okay. Now, these are the two sacs. Now, what are the two sacs? From the other picture, the red lining I told you is parietal peritoneum. And the blue lining, which was close to the visceral organ, was the visceral peritoneum. So whatever pink area you are finding here is actually called as greater sac. In the vertical disposition of the body wall, whatever this pinkish area you are finding from above downwards, whatever pink area we are finding, this is actually called as greater sac. Now, are you finding this bluish area behind the lesser omentum, behind the stomach, behind the greater omentum? Are you finding this bluish area? Yes. What is the name given to this area? Lesser sac. Okay. So, roughly, we can tell whatever area is there just behind the parietal peritoneum, in front of the stomach and many visceral organs is greater sac. And the area behind the stomach, lesser omentum, greater omentum. Whatever area you are finding here, that is lesser sac. This is the vertical disposition. Let us try to understand the horizontal disposition. I'll help you. Now see here. This is the anterior body wall. Okay, actually this is the place of liver. Now you are finding between the right and left lobe of the liver, what is the fold of peritoneum called as?
Falciform ligament.
Excellent, falciform ligament. Okay, now see here, we know like from the inferior aspect of the liver to the stomach, we have the continuation of the peritoneum.
Lesser omentum.
Very good, lesser omentum. Anterior layer is shown in red color showing this extent is all greater sac beta. Behind the lesser omentum, see, behind the lesser omentum, behind the stomach, behind the greater omentum, whatever bluish area is shown here, you call this area as lesser sac. What is this area behind the lesser omentum, behind the stomach, behind the greater omentum, this bluish area, what is the name given to this bluish area?
Lesser sac.
Lesser sac. Okay, then this all, the one which is bounded with red line everywhere, what is this area? What is this pinkish area we have used?
Greater sac.
Now, I will tell you the boundaries and everything as we elaborate. So, there is a communication between greater sac and lesser sac by means of a passage. There is a hole through which the greater sac and lesser sac are communicating, and the name of this opening is epiploic foramen. What is the name of this opening?
Epiploic foramen.
Again, I will elaborate slowly. I am taking so that you understand everything. Epiploic foramen. Okay. Now, see here. Now this is all peritoneal cavity. No, but whatever you are finding in orange, whatever you are finding in yellow color, this is all greater sac, which is now divided by the transverse colon, is the plane of cutting. We are dividing the plane of this greater sac at colon, transverse colon. Above the colon, whatever area is there, you call this compartment as supracolic compartment. Below this plane, whatever area is there, we call it as infracolic compartment. Supracolic compartment and infracolic compartment. Okay. Now, what is this blue area? Is it greater sac or lesser sac?
Lesser sac.
Lesser sac.
Very good. What is this orange, red area and yellow area. What is this area together? It is all very good.
Greater sac.
Greater sac. Okay. Okay. So we are dividing the greater sac into two compartments. That is the supra and infracolic compartments. Now, we are now initially talking about lesser sac. Where is the lesser sac present? Behind the stomach, right? This is the stomach, behind the stomach. So what you are doing here, you are, now you see here, this is liver and this is stomach. Okay, before I take you to lesser sac, I'll take you to few pictures better so that you will understand very clearly. This is liver, right? This partition is diaphragm, okay? Actually, this is pleura, parietal pleura. Below this, we have the diaphragm. Below diaphragm, what is this visceral organ you are finding? What is this organ?
Liver.
Okay. We know liver is completely enclosed by the peritoneum. Peritoneal covering in the form of coronary ligament is coming down from the inferior aspect of the liver. We know the peritoneum is extending to the lesser curvature of the stomach. What is the name of this peritoneal extension from the inferior aspect of the liver to lesser curvature of the stomach?
Lesser omentum.
What is this? Lesser omentum. Okay. Now, this is the greater curvature of the stomach. This whole thing is greater curvature of the stomach. From the greater curvature of the stomach, we have one more fold. The same peritoneal covering is continuing. The peritoneum is covering the lesser curvature, covering the anterior aspect of the stomach to continue its journey downwards, forming like an apron. I'll take you to another picture, so that you will understand very clearly. Yes, better. Yes. This is Netter's atlas picture. Now you have dissected the anterior abdominal wall. We have seen first skin, superficial fascia, two layers, three oblique muscles. Then we have seen fascia transversalis, then peritoneum. Okay, parietal peritoneum. Now you are finding what? Liver, between which you are finding falciform ligament. Part of stomach is seen. That means you have to pull the stomach in order to see lesser omentum. Then what is this big apron-like structure?
Greater omentum.
Are you able to see small intestines?
Yes, ma'am.
Only small part. No, beta?
Okay.
Now you imagine yourself in dissection hall. You will understand better. Now see here, you are lifting this greater omentum. You have just put it aside upwards. Once you have lifted, this is all greater omentum beta, which you have lifted and you have put it upwards, reflected it. Once you have reflected it, then are you finding transverse colon?
Yes.
Yes. The same greater omentum is continuing its journey on transverse colon to become this transverse mesocolon.
Okay.
Okay. It's continuing its journey from the greater omentum to the transverse colon to be continued as transverse mesocolon. Here coils of intestines are cut so as to show the fold of peritoneum. You will have 5 meters like a sari, 5 meters sari, such long intestines we have. Okay. Covering them, are you finding fold of peritoneum?
Yes.
Is the fold of peritoneum covering small intestine called as
mesentery?
Okay, so that is, this is, see here beta, you will understand, this is the greater curvature of stomach. What is this big fold of peritoneum?
Greater omentum.
Actually, it has 4 layers. First layer becomes fourth layer, second layer becomes third layer. Behind, you can see it is continuing, it is getting attached to which structure?
Transverse colon.
Very good. Transverse colon. We have seen in previous picture. Behind, it is getting attached to the transverse colon to continue as what?
Transverse mesocolon.
Very good, Meghana. Transverse mesocolon. Okay. See, your journey. See, this is the inferior aspect of the liver and this is the lesser curvature of the stomach. What do we call this fold of peritoneum as?
Lesser omentum.
Excellent, Hemalatha. Okay, from here you call it as greater omentum. You are seeing the coils of intestine, but not clearly because greater omentum is intact. You didn't lift it. Okay, once you lift, you will see so many coils of small intestines like this bit. And this fold of peritoneum will be mesentery. Okay? This is what I wanted you to understand. Now I am going back with our current slide. It's taking little time. But concept you are getting. That is more important. What we were discussing, I told you in our peritoneal cavity, we have two sacs. What are those two sacs?
Greater sac, lesser sac.
Greater sac and lesser sac. Very good. Okay. Then. Now see, I told you whatever is present in front of the stomach is all greater sac. Whatever we see behind the stomach, lesser omentum, greater omentum, this bluish area is lesser sac. Here we were. Now, lesser sac. Now you have cut the greater omentum. I hope it's very clear now, isn't it? So what you have lifted? Stomach you have lifted. Once you have lifted stomach, you are finding so much of empty space here. You are able to see transverse colon also, so that you can see the journey of greater omentum back, which is attached to the transverse colon. This continuation is transverse mesocolon. So I told you, like behind the stomach, whatever space we find is lesser sac. Lesser sac is also called as omental bursa. What is the other name given? Omental bursa. What is the communication between greater sac and lesser sac called as?
Epiploic
foramen. You are finding one probe here. I will show much better picture, just an idea. Outside is greater omentum, behind stomach is lesser omentum. We are just passing a probe to show like there is a continuity of greater sac and lesser sac at this hole, at this foramen, at this opening, which is called as epiploic foramen. What do we call it as? Epiploic foramen. Okay, now let us describe. See, lesser sac is deep to the lesser omentum behind the stomach, between the two layers of greater omentum under the diaphragmine liver. Okay, deep to the epiploic foramen. Okay, see, this is our epiploic foramen. What is this fold of peritoneum from inferior aspect of the liver to lesser curvature of stomach?
Lesser omentum.
Lesser omentum. Very good. Lesser omentum. Now just observe carefully. You call this as the right free margin of lesser omentum. This right free margin of lesser omentum is showing one hole, one opening. What is the name of this opening?
Epiploic foramen.
Epiploic foramen. In front of the stomach, whatever sac is there, that is greater sac. Behind the stomach, whatever sac is there, you call it as lesser sac. And the communicating point between greater sac and lesser sac is epiploic foramen, also called as foramen of Winslow. This is 5 marks question, beta. We need to know the boundaries also. I will elaborate this. Foramen of Winslow or epiploic foramen. Internal hernias can take place. That is the importance of epiploic foramen, which is seen on the right free margin of lesser omentum, shows an opening which is communicating the greater sac with the lesser sac. Okay, now this is our greater sac beta, whatever is shown in red yellow colors, greater sac. Okay, it is seen deep to the anterior abdominal wall, this whole thing. It is seen below the diaphragm, right? Isn't it? It is seen above the pelvic visceral organs, isn't it? Then outside to the liver, outside to the stomach, outside to the duodenal, the small intestines. Whatever you are finding, all this thing is greater sac. Okay? So, to summarize, it is seen below the diaphragm, above the pelvic visceral organs, surrounding the liver, and it is completely surrounding the stomach also, transverse colon, like this. Okay? It is forming the two layers of, first and fourth layers of the greater omentum. starting from the greater curvature of the stomach. Okay, it forms the anterior surface of duodenum also and surrounds the small intestines. Okay, all this empty space area which is shown in red and yellow color is greater sac. Okay, now the greater sac is divided like by the subdivided greater omentum, see, into two areas. Whatever is shown in red color is antero, front and above. Front and above, we use the word antero, superior part. Below and behind, down and behind, you use the word postero, inferior part. So greater sac is further sub, like supracolic, infracolic compartments only, beta. The other terminology we use for supracolic, we use the word antero, superior part. For infracolic, we use the word postero, inferior part. These are the subdivisions of which area?
Greater sac.
Okay, very good. See here, we know this disposition also I tried to explain you. This is the horizontal disposition, not vertical disposition of peritoneum. This is the place where we have liver. Between the two lobes of the liver, what is the ligament do we have there?
Falciform.
Very good, Ritika. Falciform ligament divides the liver into right and left lobes. Between the two lobes, you see, there is one fold of peritoneum which is called as falciform ligament. Falciform ligament, okay, which divides the greater sac into two parts now. Okay. So, what are the two parts we have? We have right and the left. Okay. Now you have taken this section lower down at the level of small intestines, beta. What is the fold of peritoneum which is suspending the small intestines called as?
Mesentery.
Very good, mesentery. Now mesentery, if you take it as a landmark, again the greater sac is divided into two halves, isn't it? Yes. So again we have the right half and left half, which is taken little lower down. Postero inferior part is divided into right and left part by mesentery. Antero superior part is divided by this falciform ligament into right and left part by falciform ligament. Is that clear? This is little higher up. Lower down you have, okay, I'll help you with one more picture. You have taken first section at this level, supracolic compartment. Second section you have taken at this level. This is again right and left, both the side. Right and left. Here also we have right and left compartments. Okay. What is this hole I told you, which is communicating the greater sac with lesser sac?
Epiploic foramen.
Epiploic foramen. The position is, it is lying between the liver. After stomach, the first part of small intestine is called as duodenum. This is duodenum, where I am keeping the arrow. Location. What is this? Duodenum. So between the liver and duodenum, you are finding this empty, like actually there is a foramen. What is this? Epiploic foramen. So it lies between the liver and the first part of the duodenum. Behind the this fold, that is the lesser omentum. I'll tell you these boundaries. Anterior, that becomes more easy than this. Okay. Now, peritoneal cavity, we know it is divided into this greater sac, pink in color, lesser sac, blue in color. This hole where arrow is shown, where the greater sac is communicating with lesser sac, is what? What is this arrow for?
Epiploic foramen.
Epiploic foramen.
Very good. Epiploic foramen. Okay, this is our epiploic. Different pictures are shown for our better understanding. Lesser omentum extending from the inferior aspect of the liver to the lesser curvature of stomach. Okay. Now, I told you, see, epiploic foramen is either 3 marks question or 5 marks question. Very, very important, beta. Let us try to understand the boundaries of epiploic foramen. Okay. Now, see here. This is, and what is the name of this peritoneal covering?
Lesser omentum.
Very good, lesser omentum. Now, boundaries. Anteriorly, it is bounded by this border. free border of lesser omentum. This free border of lesser omentum will contain three structures which are previously in one. Can you see, if you trace, if you just cut this lesser omentum, you are finding VAD, V-A-D, VAD structures. Like for rib, I have used VAN structures. Instead of VAN, I am using D, Delhi, VAD, V-A-D. V is portal vein, A is hepatic artery, D is bile duct. Portal vein, hepatic artery, bile duct. Same thing here. Portal vein.